5 facts about Czech nature that may surprise you.
An American living in Czechia. Checking with Katrina.
Beautiful day on this beautiful boat.
This is my first time experiencing a large body of water in this country. So far I've only seen small rivers. Apparently they do have large bodies of water.
That's wrong. That's wrong. You're not doing good so far.
Nature fact number one. Czech Republic lacks natural large bodies of water. The large bodies of water you find in Czech Republic are from man-made reservoirs.
I have no clue what the name of that gun that is.
This is Orlík Castle, and this is Orlík Dam.
Oh, it's a dam.
It's a dam. This used to
that
be...
That makes sense why it's such a big body of water.
This used to be really deep down. There was a river, so this castle was really, really high, and it was a defender castle. But yeah, they flooded the whole valley, put a dam behind us. This is one of the castles that the Schwarzenberg family owned, and he still owns. It's the same family that owned Hluboká, but he was one that was born here before communists took over. There's tours, you can take tours in there, and he still has his private residence at the Schwarzenberg family.
Number two.
One thing really strange that I learned is that there's no bears here. No bears in there at all.
Centuries ago, there were plenty of brown bears in the Czech Republic. But during the 17th and 18th centuries, hunting these beautiful carnivores was extreme, and these bears were exterminated within the country. Bears survived in Slovakia, and since the 1970s, they've been occasionally coming back to the eastern part of Czech Republic, the Beskydy Mountains. The permanent return of the brown bear to Czech Republic is hindered by illegal hunting, intensive forest management, and landscape fragmentation. Bears have large territories, and males in particular sometimes travel over distances of hundreds of kilometers. So technically speaking, there possibly could be a bear that has reached these particular woods from the Beskydy Mountains, but it's highly unlikely. Number three, this country only has one poisonous snake. There are only 5 different species of snakes in the Czech Republic, and only one of them is poisonous, the common European adder. If you are bitten by an adder, you should go to the hospital immediately. But don't panic. The venom has gradual onset, and once you get to the hospital, the doctor will most likely simply monitor your health and intervene in the event of complications. In fact, from 1999 to 2020, specialists at the VFN Toxinology Center were consulted on 352 cases throughout Czech Republic. None of these cases resulted in death. Moreover, a quarter of these cases were so-called dry bites with no injection of venom. Only one quarter of the treated cases showed more than local symptoms of poisoning.
It's really not a lot of boats out here today. Camping on the edge of the river, the dam. Not sure if you can see them there, but there they are. Enjoying each other's company. Why I enjoy the front of the boat.
Number four, there's no poison ivy in the whole country, in all these woods. No poison ivy. That must be nice to go for a walk and not worry about poison ivy.
So now we're going to I've never been on this thing before.
Jo, hele, prosím tě.
Now we're going to try to stand up.
I hope you fall. Makes for better video.
Thank you very much, my love. And that's the person I married. I hope you fall so I get a better video.
And
thank you.
You're welcome. I prayed for it. Jesus loves me.
Number 5, Moldavite. The green stone found almost exclusively in South Bohemia, Czech Republic, is among the rarest gems on earth. The stone was originally called Vltavin after the Vltava River. It is only in the last few years, with the new international popularity, that the name Moldavite has taken over, as Moldol is the German name for the Vltava River. What's most interesting about these stones is that they aren't actually crystals. Unlike other gems, such as diamonds and emeralds, that have formed under pressure over thousands of years in many locations all over the world, all of the Moldavite that ever was and ever will be was created all at once when a meteorite several kilometers wide struck the Earth. There are a few other places on Earth with similar but not identical stones from other large meteor strikes, but Moldavites are the only ones in the world that are green, save a very few rare specimens found elsewhere. Over 90% of these stones, and the most interesting ones, come from a field in a town where I live, Czeské Budějovice. My husband actually bought me a set of these stones set in earrings and a necklace several years ago, and a Moldavite ring with Czech garnets. There is a growing popularity of this stone amongst the New Age movement, as they believe the stone can give special powers. Just like in most versions of Superman, Kryptonite is depicted as a green irregular stone that crashed into the Earth from outer space. It looks almost exactly like a Moldavite stone.
Don't touch that. I told you. That's Kryptonite, Superman. A little souvenir for the old hometown. I spared no expense to make you feel right at home.
But the truth is, true power only comes from the Creator himself, not from his creation.
Now we're talking. I love going fast.
If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel and hit that notification button. And check out these videos as well.